Hi, I'm here today with Erica Rose of the Bachelor Pad. Hi, Erica.
Hey.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. Have you stopped shooting the season yet?
Yeah, we stopped shooting about a month ago.
Oh, cool. What have you been doing this year? I heard you might be having some educational updates for us.
Yeah, I'm almost done with law school, and I've been taking summer school, and I finish in December.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
That's awesome. Good for you. Are you going to practice law afterwards? Or?
I think so. You know, there's like, you know, since you have a lottery, there's so many things you can do with it, but I'm definitely going to be using it, and I think entertainment law would be something really cool to get into.
You have the definite history and the experience now.
Yeah, so I'm planning on finishing school out in Texas and then probably moving back out here once I'm done.
Oh, that's great. Good for you. Texas. Yeah, I used to live there. That's
awesome. Oh, you did?
Yeah, I did.
That's so funny.
So this last episode of the Bachelor Pad was a little tough on you, huh? Mm-hmm.
It was really difficult. Like, at the time, I remember how sad I was. And because the rest of my time in the house was so much fun, it's almost like I forgot that emotional place that I was in. And then when I had to watch it again, I like had to relive that pain. And it was even harder watching it with like my mom, because she got so upset for me. Like, she was like outraged and just upset and protective over it. But then as soon as I checked my Twitter, I've gotten so many just positive tweets. Like, I've gotten literally two negative ones and like 300 or 400 like really positive
That's
ones
wonderful.
Just telling me like, who cares what those guys say? Like, we think you're beautiful inside and out. Like, you know, and I am confident with my appearance, of course. Like, most girls, I think, yeah, maybe I'd look better if I lost 5 or 10 pounds. And, you know, when I'm watching it, I'm like, oh my God, why did I not get a little bit thinner for it? But I don't think that matters. Like, I probably still would have gone hit with the eggs. For whatever reason, people felt like throwing them at me, whether it's because they weren't attracted to me or what. They just thought, they didn't care about how I would react, and they didn't worry about upsetting me. Like, they might have worried about upsetting some of the girls with, like, stronger personalities, because I do have a strong personality, but I was kind of quiet at the beginning, so I guess I was, like, an easy target.
Mm-hmm. That would fix it, yeah.
But
have you talked to any of the guys since?
Yeah, I have, and especially Michael, he's really apologized.
He looks very sad and upset over it.
Yeah, he was sincerely upset. And he felt really bad, and so he and I are close friends. We're having lunch tomorrow.
Oh, that's great.
And even Blake has apologized to me. And, you know, Jake's reached out to me, telling me that he felt really sad for me. And William even checked in with me
that's
to make
great.
Sure I was
that's
doing
nice
okay.
To hear that.
Yeah, so it's really nice that not every guy, but for most of the guys, I'm close to, like, those four guys, mm-hmm. and I really think they're good people.
I think so, too. I've met a few of them, so they're really nice guys. I heard you have some very exciting things coming up on the next episode, including
yes.
one of those guys. You want to share some of that with us?
Well, I'm just ready for next episode, because it's going to be so much more fun mm-hmm. for me than last episode, but I do have an exciting kiss coming up with Jake.
Oh!
And all I can say is, he is a good kisser.
Oh, he is? Okay.
He's definitely, he had his practice on The Bachelor, and now he knows what he's doing.
That's right, he was The Bachelor, yeah. He got a few of them in there.
Yeah, I didn't understand why I was the only girl that was, like, interested in him. I'm like, hi, like, these other guys are cute, but Jake was The Bachelor. Like, these guys weren't. Like, to me, that means he's the biggest catch in the house, so
that's
I'm
true.
Gonna concentrate on him, like, not these other guys. You know?
you were thinking clearly.
Yeah, I felt when I was hanging out with Jake, I felt like I was back on The Bachelor, but with, like, a better Bachelor than I had my season.
Yeah, I think I might have to agree with you there a little bit.
Yeah.
But you're friends with Vienna. Didn't that make the situation difficult?
It did, and actually, like, well, Casey and I were really good friends mm-hmm. coming into the house.
Oh, beforehand, okay.
But Vienna and I had only met once, and we weren't as close as Casey and I were. So, you know, I didn't feel like I had any loyalties towards her at that point. And so I felt like I could do what I want with Jake. But since then, since Jake left, you know, since we all left the house, and since Vienna and I hung out since the show, she came in town, and my dad did her nose and everything.
Oh, she did, okay.
So we became, like, a lot closer after the show, I think, than we were on it.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, and we're so close now that I think it would be harder for me to have the relationship with Jake mm-hmm. going forward than it was while we were in the house. So even when I'm saying
that... So there's no romance right now?
I mean, we'll see. Oh. We haven't hung out since the show,
okay.
But maybe next week he might be back in LA. We might be here at the same time.
That'd be nice.
But it's just difficult because I wouldn't want to damage. My priority now has to be my friendship with Vienna because we've gotten so close. And when you're really good friends with someone, you don't date their exes.
Mm-hmm.
But on the show, we weren't really good friends, so I felt like he was open game for sure.
Sure. Do you have any news coming out for us or anything else you want to tell your fans?
Well, I want them to get excited for, I have this new workout DVD I made with my trainer. And it's called the Stiletto Bikini Blast, and it's a really fun workout you can do in your bikini and stilettos, mm-hmm. and it works well for any body type. If you are curvaceous like me, or my trainer She's really skinny. It works. It just, it's about making everyone have fun while they work out and look the best for their body. So they can see that on stilettobikiniglass.com.
Thank you. I was going to ask, where can we find that? Because yes. I'm interested. That's that really fun.
It's in Dr. Phil endorsed it when I was on the show. It's like, you need to make this.
I watched that episode, by the way. You and your mom.
Yeah, it was fun. So he was the one that gave me the idea because I was doing the workout in my little background package on the show. And he's like, you need to make this a DVD. So I'm like, Dr. Phil thinks so, I will.
Cool, very cool.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Erica. It was really a pleasure sitting down and talking to you.
Me too.
I look forward to you and Jake's episode next week.
Thanks.